This is all that's left of three apartment buildings in Lewiston that caught fire yesterday afternoon. A backhoe was brought in to tear down two of those three buildings. And good evening. Thanks for joining us tonight. I'm Tracy Sable. The fire was so intense that it burned through 35 apartments and left 75 people homeless. And new tonight, the fire chief says that one of those buildings had actually been condemned, but despite that, some people were still living there. WMTW News H. Jim Keithley is live on the scene for us tonight, and he has the latest on the investigation. Jim?
Well, Tracy, Lewiston's fire chief says that every single investigator with the state fire marshal's office was on scene here today. Some spent the entire night. We want to give you a look now at what's left of the scene. Not much, as you can see. Now, because two of the three buildings were partially collapsed, it wasn't safe for investigators to get inside today. And tonight, still no word on what caused this massive fire. A giant backhoe was brought in to tear down what was a towering apartment building at 105 Blake Street in Lewiston. When it caught fire yesterday, it quickly spread to two other buildings. 75 people lived here. Nobody was seriously hurt. They stood and watched. As many people said, the flames were like nothing they had ever seen before.
Everybody sort of knows each other. And It was just scary, just seeing how fast it went.
Eight investigators from the state fire marshal's office were on scene today. They took pictures and gathered what evidence they could, but the buildings were not safe to enter, so two of them had to be demolished.
A great deal of speculation, you know, with regard to the cause, and just, you know, officially we want to say that remains under investigation. We haven't made any determinations, and we want to be certain when we do make that public that, you know, we're well-grounded and it's backed up with fact.
Witnesses said they heard explosions, but the fire chief said people shouldn't read too much into that.
It's not, you know, uncommon when there's a fire of that magnitude to hear those types of noises, explosions, you know, glass breaking.
An investigator with the state fire marshal's office says with today's codes, new construction of this type of apartment building would require a sprinkler system. But the chief says it's still to be determined if this building even had working smoke detectors.
All the multi-unit properties in the state of Maine are required to have smoke detectors. And you know, if you have tenants, and that's, you know, part of our enforcement effort is to ensure that these buildings do have smoke detectors, so I really can't comment on, you know, the status of that building. It was certainly a building I'll call in transition. It was, had been condemned. It was in the process of being vacated.
One day later, not all was lost. The backhoe crew delicately removed debris and saved this woman's car. Now, investigators moved their command post from the fire scene here to Lewiston PD. We understand that they're interviewing people connected with the case, so we're going to stay on this, and we'll bring you the latest developments as we get them. We're live at Lewiston. Jim Keithley, WMTW News 8.